You see, we failed in our quest to convert the Osmonds, particularly the Merrill Osmond family, to the Protestant faith. We got to know Merrill very well by just following him around with cameras. The more we got to know him, we really felt like that we needed to save them. We needed to share the gospel with them.
And the day came when the Malcolms came to me and wanted me to do an album.
Yeah, so we pitched an idea of a gospel CD to Merrill, and he liked the idea.
A gospel album to Merrill Osmond was more like I Am a Child of God, and you know, and those kinds of hymns that we do in our church.
He did just an amazing job in the studio recording those. And I remember after one take, he came out and he said, you know, these aren't songs we typically do in our Mormon church. And I was thinking, yeah, he's listening. So we had no clue at the time, but it was a great experience. And it really worked out well. The CD turned out great. We took it on the road.
We went to Arizona one day, I remember, and we went out to a restaurant and we were talking, and this is when Mike got pretty bold. He started to ask me questions.
I was so nervous, you know, that I was going to challenge him on it, and I wasn't going to be rude about it or anything, but I just remember the whole meal I was eating and not saying much because I was trying to think of how to say, and finally I couldn't think of anything brilliant, so I just said, why do you guys have to have the Book of Mormon? Isn't the Bible enough?
So he got bolder. And so the more he got bold, the more I got bold, and we started talking about specifics, the Godhead, the pre-existence, and all of those things. I don't know what happened there, but there was a little bit of a shift, I think on their side, hopefully.
That was kind of what broke the ice. You know, from there we had many, many gospel discussions.
We kept our conversations going, but I challenged them to read the Book of Mormon. And they both said they would do that, but they wanted me to read some of their literature, which I agreed to do.
Its very purpose is to the convincing of the Jew and Gentile that Jesus is the Christ, the eternal God, manifesting himself unto all nations. There's a power in this book that can touch the hearts and lift the lives of honest seekers of truth. Invite your friend to read the book prayerfully.
And I do have a firm testimony of the Book of Mormon. The Book of Mormon, we started out thinking that it was not true, it was not a good book, we shouldn't be reading it. And we went through the process of actually reading it, opening up, studying it. And then we felt like we should pray about it.
We always opened our studies with prayer, but we actually talked about needing to specifically pray. And I just remember telling Mike, I just said, somewhere in the Book of Mormon, it says to pray about it and that God would answer you if it's true or not, if you prayed with an open and honest heart. So Mike said that was a pretty bold statement for any book to make, and so we did pray about it. We did find the scripture in Moroni 10:4.
We prayed about it, and we did get that confirmation from the Holy Ghost that is true, and it continues to bless our lives.
We felt a great peace in praying about it, and so we knew then that we needed to continue on and study and learn. I told Mike, I said, I want to be baptized. The next step in this adventure is for me to be baptized.
I remember one trip to Branson, and after the brothers did their show, Janie and I went up to Merrill's room, and his brother Wayne was there, and we were talking. We were talking about the gospel. Actually, that night, we came after we'd been studying a long time, so we actually had a lot of questions that night, and so we were talking a lot, and then we started talking about Olive, Merrill's mom, and she had had a recent stroke, and she had been such a strong influence to us, and we didn't know if we'd ever get to talk to her again. He said, well, I talked to her earlier. I think she's doing okay. So he picks up his cell phone, and he calls Olive and hands the phone to Jane, and Jane talks to her for a minute, and she said, yeah, Olive, and I want to be baptized. And I couldn't hear, but I really could kind of hear through the phone Olive asking the question, what about Mike? So Jane just looks at me and hands me the phone, and I pick it up, and I was like, hi, Olive, I'm getting baptized too. And it was at that moment that I knew that I was going to be baptized. I actually knew in my heart I should be, and just the joy of telling her.
So I guess it was December 2002 when we were with Marilyn, and when we got on the phone with Olive. And after we got off the phone with Olive, we looked at Marilyn and said, well, looks like we're going to be baptized, and we are excited about it, and we would like you to baptize us. And so we started talking about when we can do it, and he pulled out his schedule, and he had a lot of things going on, but he said, I'll be back in Ephraim, Utah on March 20th of 2003. And we said, well, that's great. We can arrange our schedules, and we'll come out for that. That made for a wonderful, mm-hmm. wonderful baptism with him there.
I think for me that joining the church was, I walked into it with an unknown, and I am in it, and I love it. I just know that the fullness of the gospel is here. I love the gospel. I love all that I'm learning. My relationship with Jesus Christ and Heavenly Father is far beyond I ever dreamed it could ever be.
Once you know and get the perspective of why you're here, then that changes how you live your life. And I just have such a testimony of this gospel and the scriptures and the prophets. And I look forward to the rest of my life here and the eternities with my family. I'm Mike Malcolm.
And I'm Jane Malcolm.
And sometimes it's okay to fail.
It certainly is. I know with all of my heart and with every thought that I have that the decision that I made to be baptized into the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints is one of the most remarkable decisions I have ever made for myself and for my family.
I love my Savior, Jesus Christ. I have such strong feelings of His love for me and my love and desire that I have to worship Him. I'm Mike Malcolm.
And I'm Jane Malcolm.
And we're failures.